Many people are a little bit overwhelmed when they first start working with databases, but they really shouldn't be so scary. In working with Excel, you are actually working with something that can act as a flat file or two-dimensional database. That means that you could record table data in Excel. And when you're working with table data, you're having a two-dimensional database, and the two dimensions are records and fields. You can see here that I've put in some different tables that will eventually relate to each other, but each table has rows which represent records. Each record is completely about one entity, in this case one person. What I have on the screen here is a simplified representation of a database for a school, and it does not by any stretch of the imagination have all of the tables, but it shows you two possible tables that could be related to each other in a query, which basically creates a new table by grabbing fields or columns from other tables and linking them together. So if we were to create a database on student information, you'd create potentially a student table, and you would need to have a unique field to identify each record. And since you can have names repeating, you would typically create a field like student ID. That would become your key field. A key field uniquely identifies a record. And each table usually will have one key field that you can use that will reference an entire row or record in it. Over here we have an example of a course list. Sometimes you just assign a number, typically where you're counting and just giving the next number in a row, like a student ID, social security number, or employee ID. But here we're creating a key field based on information in the record. So for example, if you're offering 30 or 40 sections of computer literacy each semester, you could represent a specific section by putting in the semester, spring, the year, 15, the department, the number, and the section. Those things taken together will uniquely identify a specific section of computer literacy. And you could create a course code that both the computer and humans could read that indicates that it's spring 2015 CDM 110036. That won't duplicate. You could have another record like that in the fall, but the letters would be different. So that forms a key field for this course list table. So there are some key definitions you need to know before going forward. Our records are our rows, and they each represent one entity, and our fields are our columns. And you only have one type of data in any given field. If your field is first name, you would not put a phone number in it. You can combine different tables in a relational database using something called a query that will select information from each table, and it doesn't need to use all of the information, just specific pieces. So we could combine information from the student table, information from the course list table, and add additional columns either from another table, or possibly this would be listed with the course list, tuition and fees, and we could come up with a bill. We could use student information plus course list information and put in grades, and we could create a report card. So it really lets us keep track of a lot of different related data, which is why it's called a relational database. So your key terms that you need to know are a record, which is information about one entity, a field, which contains one type of data, a key field, which uniquely identifies a record. The other piece of vocabulary you need is a foreign key. A foreign key links to a key field in another table. So that's your basic vocabulary for relational databases, and now we can start working in Access.